This is fantastic. This Concours here on the grass.
A Concours de provenance, as opposed to a Concours de elegance.
Ah.
And it is, I think, the first time this has been done in the Midwest since maybe the beginning of time, because it originated on the West Coast about 5 years ago with a vintage group called the Fabulous 50s.
Oh, yes.
And what we have here is a bunch of cars that are being judged that for their provenance. In other words, their racing history in period, and if they've had any more recent vintage racing history. And those are the two most important things, and points are awarded on that scale, and the trophies are awarded appropriately.
Fantastic.
So we're big into patina and not so much into trailer queens.
Tom, you've got clearly one of the neatest cars on the grass. What exactly is this?
Thank you. This this car behind us is an example of a 1970s sports race car, an FIA sports racer. This is the kind of car that raced at Le Mans in 1970 and 71. The in those years, the FIA had a 5-liter engine displacement limit.
Right.
So this was Ferrari's response to that class. Porsche's response was the 917.
17, yeah.
Yeah, both of those were featured in the Steve McQueen movie, Le Mans. So if you saw that movie, this is one of those kind of cars. It's this is one of 25 that the factory built. Most all of them were privateer cars. It's a 5-liter V12, about 550 horsepower. It's an awesome car. It's just a lot of rubber on the road, very aerodynamic, and a wonderful car to drive.
Oh, the sound of these cars are really incredible. Now, do you campaign this car?
Yeah, I've owned this car for a great many years and have vintage raced it all during that time, the last almost 20 years.
The 20 owner, years.
Yeah, the owner before me had it for about 15 years, and he vintage raced it during all that period of time. Interesting story is that in 1971, that was the year this car raced at Le Mans, where it broke, it didn't finish. But in 1972, the FIA decreed a 3-liter limit on engines.
Well,
so these 5-liter cars became obsolete. So the owner of this car, a Swiss by the name of George Filippinetti, therefore the name Scuderia Filippinetti for the team, took the car back to the castle, to his castle, and there it sat for about a year, until an American came through and bought it, brought it to this country, and put it in a Can-Am race in Riverside.
Really?
So where it was campaigned in 72 and again in 73. So it has a Can-Am history as well as an FIA World Sports Car history.
Wow. Who drove it at Riverside?
Actually the same person who drove it at Le Mans, an Englishman by the name of Mike Parks.
Oh. Wow, so this has history on both sides of the pond.
Yeah, and it's an ever been crashed car. It's got a continuous history of ownership. It's a no, as they say, a no stories car.
Right.